Good evening. Welcome to Atlantis Has Talent 2017. My name is Mrs. Wallach, and we have a great show planned for you tonight. The sponsors of the talent show, Coach Hansen, Mrs. Marks, Mr. Blecker, and myself, auditioned about over 30 acts for the talent show and chose 11 to perform on the stage tonight. The contestants are students from 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th grade. We have invited a special set of judges to be a part of the show. We'd like them to stand at this time. There are two backstage also. Hold on. You'll see them in a moment. There's a surprise planned. So we have Ms. Poston, Ms. Petty, Mr. Yant, Mrs. Jones, and Mrs. Rucker. The judges will be scoring the students to decide the top three acts of the night. Please remember that they're judging the students and not our technology, so thank you for being understanding of any technological issues that might occur. We would like to thank the other staff members who helped support and plan this event. Thank you to our administration for always supporting our efforts. Is Principal Adams here? So thank you, Principal Adams. Thank you to all the classroom teachers who helped students practice, calm nerves, and came out tonight to support their students. Thank you to Mrs. Wilkinlow. She's going to be helping me backstage. I want to say a special thank you to a few extra parents. I'm trying to do something here.
But I thought it was a talent show.
Yeah, like. Well, it's for people like with talent. So
what if you showed me a few chords? Could I get better? Practice makes perfect. Yeah. You are the music teacher.
Wait, right here?
Well, we got time. You guys got time? Okay, so. What do we do?
All right, you want to do an E minor. So okay. You have one finger here, okay. And then one finger there, okay. and then strum it. Let's try a C chord. Yeah. So put this one here, and then that one there, and that one there.
Yeah?
Yep, push on really hard. Okay, let's try, since you got those two right. So quickly, let's try G. Okay. So put this one here, right. That one there.
Okay.
And that one. Right there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
And then just.
Yep.
That's not good.
Oh, well, wait, hold on. Yeah, there you go.
Is that good?
Yeah. He's a quick learner. Okay, one more. Yeah. Okay, so let's do D. So put one here,
okay.
And then one there, and one there. That's yeah. D. Ooh.
That doesn't sound. Clap for that.
So if you put them together, it's called a chord progression. You want to try that?
Okay. I'm ready.
Let's try it as a progression.
All right, so it's.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And I keep going. Baby, I don't need dollar bills to have fun tonight. Baby, I don't.
Further, we should do that.
That's not. I mean, it's not what we plan to do, but.
Maybe next time, next talent show.
Yeah.
Next time, I guess.
You guys want to see it?
Yeah!
So we have a surprise performance for you first.
Yeah.
Here at Atlantis is that I got a group of teachers and staff together, and we worked on that song. We called it an orchestra, because those instruments are called orph instruments. So when we put them together, it's an orchestra. So the students actually will see a video recording of it on Friday in the morning announcements, so you guys got a sneak preview. I do want to finish thanking a few more people. I wanted to thank some really helpful parents. So. During auditions, we had some help from Mrs. Cope, Mrs. Samoski, and Mrs. Burns. So thank you for helping us on audition day. I also wanted to thank a few parents that were here to help me today, help us today. So thank you to Mrs. Bennett and to Mrs. McFarland. Thank you. And Mrs. Armstrong. And finally, thank you to the custodians and the aftercare staff that are always so flexible. They are such an important part of our team. But one last thing before we get started. This evening, we did not have a ticket price because we wanted to be able to let anyone come who wanted to come. But we will be accepting donations at the end of the show that will benefit the music program. So anything that you are willing to donate to our music program will be appreciated. We're looking to purchase some new instruments, such as baby ukuleles, some new xylophones and mallets, and upgrading some of the instruments that we already have that need some repairs. So anything that you might be able to give us for the music program, we dearly appreciate it.
And we have a box here that we'll pass around later, but I also want to recognize the guy who's about to walk out. That's Mr. Eddie Wallach. She used to be Beth Olson. Do you remember that? A long time ago, earlier this year? And now, she's Mrs. Wallach, thanks to this guy over here. He's going to be recording the show for us tonight. So big thanks to Eddie. Now you're not in trouble. I think we're ready for the show. Are we ready? All right. So, it's not easy going first. All right, but our first performer is going to have some Rubik's Cubes, but actually, Tommy, I think you're going to come out here real quick, correct? He's going to do a little backstory about his Rubik's Cube, and he needs Mr. Young as a... Are they trying to tell him something? Is it over already? That's okay. That's all right. I'll work on my balance. You're fine. Is Tommy coming out? Come on out, Tommy. So he's going to explain a little bit about what you're about to see. We had to do his performance a little differently because he's going to be using Rubik's Cubes, but it's hard to see his hands from all the way back there. So we're going to put his hands and Rubik's Cube on top of the dog cam. You're going to watch it live on the screen, so it's very high tech. So Tommy's going to explain a little bit more.
Good evening. My name is Tommy Brower. And by a show of hands, how many of you can solve a Rubik's Cube?
One and a half.
It's good. Okay. Well, tonight I'm going to solve four in under 4 minutes, so hope you enjoy.
So give it up one more time for Thomas Brower. So one more thing. It's like an obstacle course. So, right now they're already put together. We actually need to get them scrambled up. So, Mr. Yan, if you don't mind maybe finding a volunteer or two. Oh, wait, time out. I forgot. We're going to let our judges do it. Make it difficult for Tommy, please. All right. Tommy, I'll collect him and bring him up to you. So, we're going to give him 5 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. It's like taking FSA, you're finished. Bye, pencils down. All right, I think we're ready. Tommy, right here, buddy. You keep moving all over on me here. There's one more. He has not started yet, by the way. Is it on?
Blurry.
They're saying it's blurry. Can you see it now? Hang on, Tommy, you're going so fast.
Okay.
Okay, right there. Hey, there we go. So I don't know if you guys can see, but he has a timer going, and he's at 38 seconds right now. We're going to figure out how long it takes him to do all four.
I got
when we move, well, you already know. Since the last
It is 2 minutes and 38 seconds. Great job. How long have you been doing the Rubik's Cube?
Since third grade.
And why third grade? Why'd you start third grade?
Well, because I went to this parent thing, or not parent thing, like this night for math, and if you got them all right, you get a prize. So I chose the Rubik's Cube.
Who happened to be?
Uh-oh, locked down.
Mike, we'll keep rocking. Who was your third grade teacher?
This week's.
Yes. Anybody else like that?
Earlier, there's like a system of how you can figure it out. Do you mind sharing? It's not like a top secret thing. How do you figure it out?
Well, to sum it up, you do first two layers, and then you do the last layer all in algorithms that you have to memorize.
That's all, just algorithms. Just do two layers in algorithms. Best time ever to do just the 4x4. What was your best time just on the one?
4x4 or 3x3?
Any of them.
Oh, 3x3 is 15 seconds. 4x4, it's like minute 15. And 2x2 is like one.
So for all four of them together, you got 238, which is really fast for everybody here. But what is your best on all four?
Like 205.
Whoa. Like 205, yeah. So any advice for people out there that have never used a Rubik's Cube, what should they do as soon as they get it besides taking off the stickers and fixing it like you guys did when you were kids?
Don't get frustrated. It'll eventually come. You just have to practice.
And how can you relate that to their schoolwork?
Well, school is hard at first, but then once you practice, you get better.
Very good. Tell me any big plans. So after you leave elementary school, you're heading to middle school. Any big plans after you finish schooling?
Engineer.
Oh, that's awesome. Engineer. Any type of engineering that you're thinking about?
Electrical.
Ooh, any other electrical engineers in the house? Ah, look at that. I think that's Daddy over there. That's a great idea. Mrs. Wallach, I'm waiting on you. Are we good? We are good. Give it up one more time for Tommy.
I'm shutting off the mic, so I'm taking a hit. But our next performer is Mr. Luke Nunez playing a rock and roll band.
Guitar! Who are you? Where
period here quick. Let's give it up one more time for Luke, because it's not easy. As I know, giving up your work is hard. Thankfully, Mrs. Wallach was here to help me, but she didn't help Luke at all. Luke, how'd you become such a great guitar player?
Well, I really liked listening to Aerosmith, so I said I want to play guitar, so I got listening.
So no offense to you, but you're a little bit past Aerosmith's prime. Like, I grew up with Aerosmith, right, as many of you did. So how did you get into, like, old school classic rock?
Well, my dad used to listen to it in the car, and I used to always like it.
That sound familiar to you guys, too? My son's all of a sudden like Green Day. I think it's my fault. So, how long do you practice guitar? Like, give me an average day you go home. I'm sure you do your homework. Right, Luke, you do your homework. Okay. Probably baseball practice. And then, how long do you play guitar? How long do you practice every day?
20, but if I can, 45 minutes.
Very good. Have you ever performed in front of an audience this big before?
Yeah.
Where did you perform?
Celebration, Florida.
Celebration. Well, what did you do in Celebration? Why did you perform there?
It was a Memorial Day thing, and I played the God Bless America.
Very good. And actually, if I do recall, didn't you play for an assembly out there in the courtyard? Right? And that's a bigger crowd than this right here. So now that I'm thinking about it, you did perform for everybody. Mrs. Wallach, how are we doing back there? We are all set. Give it up one more time for Luke Duda. Tyler, you're gonna do it. Alright, so our next performer, a third grader, and we have Miss Sarah Bennett, and she's going to be singing a song. So get ready and enjoy. Stand in front of the mirror and they would practice singing like that. Did you guys ever do that? So how do you, right? You just get batteries for your hairbrush too to make sure it's on. How do you practice at home? Like, do you use your big sister Katie that's out there? Like, who's your audience at home and how do you practice at home?
Well, actually, usually I practice at my dance studio, but But sometimes I practice at home.
Very good. And do you have a favorite, out of all the singers in the world, besides Mrs. Wallach, who's your favorite singer?
Katy Perry.
I don't blame you there. I don't blame you there. Now, you look like Snow White today. Do you have a favorite out of all the seven dwarves? Who's your favorite?
Toby.
You're not talking about me, right? Just coincidentally, I just happen to be here. All right, Sarah, we're going to sneak through here. Give it up one more time for Sarah. Thank you. She did it on purpose. So next we have Emma Johnson, a fourth grader who is also going to sing. So get ready. Thank you.